I was always embarrassed about listening music too loud and all that. I remember my mom had a small Fiat, and she always listened to music loud. Me and my sister were sitting in the back of the car, and my mom listened to music loud. I tried to hide, because I felt embarrassed. I ended up in a summer camp. It was 1987, I think, and I heard a guitar riff. I clearly remember that one. There was a Flash for Fantasy from Billy Idol, and I mean, I didn't even have any idea about musical styles or punk rock or guitar or anything. This guitar just stuck in my head. And I think that was the point when it embedded itself to me. I started collecting all kinds of old Hungarian punk rock tapes, and of course, you know, the stuff that was going on, Exploited and Discharge and GBH and Finnish hardcore bands, whatever I was able to put my hands on. I made a copy of it. I had it. I listened to it. So the underground existed in Hungary before the regime changed, but it was still new. I mean, if you had a Mohawk and you were in the wrong place at the wrong time, you had to be a good runner. You were outnumbered if you were a punk rocker. Or again, I mean, you had your chances to end up with a bruised up knuckle or a broken nose. So what do you do when your mom is out for the weekend and grandma is watching you? You go get a Mohawk. You go to the hairdresser and get a Mohawk, and that's what I did. I really wanted to have my hair colored, right? And I figured out something. I'm like, I'm gonna use shoe polish. When I stepped onto the bus, I'm telling you, everybody walked away. I mean, I probably smelled like a shoe store or something. I don't know. I met one guy in downtown. We made pretty good friends, and he took me to the Black Hole, to the club, the first time. And, you know, I believe that was 1989. And from that point, I was there every weekend. I mean, that's where I spent most of my time. And that's where I had my first experience with girls. That was the first time when I was with a girl, and that was pretty much in a park next to the Black Hole, the club. It was in the bushes, I remember, but it was awesome. I didn't want to have a guitar, and my mom bought me a really cheap guitar. It's called Joanna. It was a really bad guitar. I mean, I still really like it. I still have one, but that was my first guitar. I could not play it at all. I didn't know what to do with it, but I really wanted to play. So I started listening to some of these old tapes that I had, and after that I had a couple of friends help me out learning chords and how to play the guitar the right way, you know. I never had a guitar teacher. I never went to guitar school. You can probably hear that. Black Hole, the club was always open till 4 in the morning. And Mike and I, we were just leaving the place and everybody was going home. And we started talking about music. And we decided we were going to start a band together. And that's when basically the first band I ever played in started. It was CEFB. We started practicing at Mike's mom's living room. It was in the worst possible area of Budapest. It was the 8th district. I remember the street called Sigony Street. And it was a pretty famed area at that time. It had a pretty bad reputation. And well, that's where he lived, and that was the only place we were able to practice. So we had a little amplifier for the bass and some stuff for the guitar, and we started writing songs, listening to bands we liked, and started writing our first songs. But we didn't have a drummer. So Mike brought one of his classmates from school, and he actually was a guitarist, but he had some idea how to play drums, so he was our first drummer. We played 2 shows with him, and then later he left the band. And that's when Emmanuel joined to the band as drummer, who recorded our 1992 demo with us and the 1993 album, which later actually came out on Trottel Records. And after that, things started falling apart.
Let us go.